Well, I started playing the piano when I was about 6 or 7, and then songs when I was about 11 or 12. My parents weren't very musical, and no one in my family was very musical. So it was weird that I wanted to do it so badly. But yeah, my grandmother was really wanted me to play the piano. Well, she really wanted my sisters to play the piano, but I sort of convinced her to give me the lessons. When I first moved up to London, it was quite a shock of living in, you know, such a big city and sort of looking around, and I guess although there's like millions of people in London and there's so much culture, which is a huge inspiration for the album, at the same time, you know, there's so many people that are like, without sounding kind of cheesy, but there's so many like lonely people, you know, you see them on the tube, and there's a lot of that in a big city, which I think inspired the album a bit. There's a song called Sirens, which is the last track on the album, which is kind of inspired in Brighton as well as London, but it's kind of about when you know, like, it's 1 o'clock in the morning, you hear sirens, and it's just always fascinated me, you know, because it's like you don't know where those ambulances or police cars are going, but you know it's like somewhere. It's like, it's weird, cause it's like a cry, isn't it? Of badness. I think I would, I find that when I haven't written a song for like more than, I don't know, like a couple of weeks, I go completely nuts. Like, because I have nothing to do and I have nothing to put my energy into. I think it gets to a point where you're, you know, touring or whatever, and you can't choose every image that goes on every blog in the world, but I try and have this, you know, I am a bit of a control freak. But yeah, I mean, yeah, if I sat there every night and thought about Adele and Emily Sandin winning that award, it would probably, I probably wouldn't get much sleep, but yeah. Which if anything is just, you know, it's kind of crazy, because, but then again, I think, you know, they have been ruling the charts.
Yeah.
I just want to make the best music I can make. I've never really had any conscious decision to set myself apart from anyone. I guess I enjoy both, really. Like, I really enjoy the recording process, and it's good to get your head really into that. And then going out and touring is nice, because it's, you know, visiting different cities, and it's just good fun. Probably playing on Jules Holland, like, that was for me a huge, you know, I grew up watching Jules Holland on TV and still watch it.
Yeah.
When it's, you know, when it's on, and like to be on it, and it was the last show ever in the old BBC Television Centre in White City, so that was pretty cool. It felt like, for me, it was a real, you know, I still can't really believe I was on the Jules Holland Centre, but I still haven't got any money, so so like I don't. I don't know. I know what she means. I mean, I don't really. I mean, I do think about songwriting and about, things can't be too comfortable. I do think that if you've got a nice flat and, you know, a great girlfriend or boyfriend, it's like, you know, I find it. I mean, I've only a few times in my life have I really felt, you know, very content with my surroundings. I think it's good to be a bit, you know, which is a weird thing to say, because you want to be happy as a person, but I think it makes you, you're too comfortable, you've got nothing to be passionate about, you know. Sense, which was on the EP, I'm really proud of that song, because it wasn't written really that long ago, and I was, you know, I'm just proud of it, and I'm proud of it.